Good evening. My name is Abigail McKee. I'm Executive Director of Portland Baroque Orchestra, and it is my very great pleasure to welcome you to our first ever attempt at live streaming a concert. 48 hours ago, we thought that this hall was going to be full of about 500 friends. And tonight, instead, we are here in a hall that is largely empty, except for our staff and our musicians. We are therefore thrilled to be able to bring this to you tonight. This is a very weird experience for us, and this is our first time trying this, so I hope that you will forgive us for any technical issues that we might encounter, but we are so happy to be here for this experiment, and we're incredibly grateful, primarily to each of our musicians, for taking this risk with us. This is a really interesting time for all of us, and I think in moments like this, it is the power of great art that brings us together. We're used to the arts bringing us together, and all of us being in the room at the same time. But tonight, we're together in spirit and through the internet. This performance, therefore, is shared in celebration of the human spirit. We're all in this together, and tonight it is our privilege to bring great music to you. So, tonight's concert is Theatrical Concerti. It's being led by Carla Moore, and now I'm going to turn it over to Carla and the musicians of Portland Baroque Orchestra.
Thank you.
So I've already caught the first error, which is that I didn't tell you what that was. We opened the program today with Introduzione Teatrale in G major by Locatelli. And you can download a PDF of the program and the program notes at pbo.org. We're going to do our best to remember to walk you through all of the things, but I will tell you my pronunciation will be imperfect at best. Thank you for your patience. We will continue the program with Telemann's Overture Burlesque in B-flat major.
Thank you.
The pieces on this program are all theatrical in nature, and the next two works are the most literal. I just realized you guys were going to tune before I talked.
Oh, that's okay.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and talk to you now. This is real life, folks. Thanks. For the next two pieces, we are going to welcome CEO and President of All Classical Portland, Suzanne Nance, who will be our narrator. The first piece by Murray is a notorious and gruesome description of an 18th century surgery, and following that is a Telemann suite inspired by Jonathan Swift's novel, Gulliver's Travels. Please stand by while we reset the stage, tune, and then we'll be right back with you.
The operation for the removal of the stone. The sight of the surgical device. At the sight. The decision to mount the table, arriving at the top. The restraining device is lowered. Serious reflections. The tying down of the arms and legs. Incision is made. The forceps are inserted. The stone is removed. The patient's voice falters. The blood flows out. Silk ties are unknotted. The patient is taken to bed. The convalescence. The
we were saying. The introduction. The jig of the Brobdingnagische.
Thank you.
daydreams of the Lilliputians and their attendant flappers. The lure of the well-mannered Houyhnhnms, along with the wild dance of the untamed Yahoos.
Thank you.
will conclude this first half of the program with Zavattieri's Concerto Teatrale in F major. And following that, we're going to take a 15-minute intermission, because that's really not just so that audience members can go have a break and get a cookie. It's actually so our musicians can go get a drink of water and take a rest for a moment. So we will be back with you following intermission today, but please enjoy first Zavattieri's Concerto Teatrale in F major.
Thank you.
So again, thank you for joining us for this first half of Theatrical Concerti with Portland Baroque Orchestra. We will be back after 15 minutes at 8:30 p.m., but for now, intermission.
Cut.
Guys, amazing job.
I didn't know you were going to talk. It's so fun. You know what? It's fine. It's all good.
So we're getting lots of text messages from people who are watching and loving this.
Yes.
We think, Matt, you said how many? Welcome back. And if you are just joining us, my name is Abigail McKee. I'm Executive Director of Portland Baroque Orchestra, and it's such a pleasure to welcome you back for the second half of our concert, Theatrical Concerti. We are live streaming tonight's performance, and we are thrilled to have you with us. Before we embark on the second half, I do just want to remind you that we are in a time right now when artists and musicians are among our most vulnerable financially. And I want to just urge you, as you're watching the second half, to take a moment to support any arts organization, because without your support, we cannot continue producing these incredible concerts with these incredible artists. So whether it's for Portland Baroque Orchestra or anyone else that you care about, please take a moment in the second half to consider making a donation to any arts organization to allow great art and great music to continue during this really interesting time that we're living in. Now, we're going to turn it back over to the musicians, and we are going to open the second half with another Locatelli Introduzione Teatrale. That went really well. This one in D major. Thank you. Tempo Concerto. It features a soloist and an orchestra on stage, and a second soloist and a small backup band somewhere else in the hall. And Carla Moore will be our violin soloist on stage, and Rob Diggins will be our violin soloist in the hall. Once they're in position, we'll begin Vivaldi's Concerto in A Major for violin and three violins per Echo in Lontano. And while they're getting in position, let's just acknowledge that, yes, I am wearing tennis shoes. I forgot my shoes. It's a recurring nightmare come to life. Here we are. Thank you all for the comments and the text messages. Here we are. So, with that said, let's get back to being very serious with some Vivaldi.
Thank you.
will close tonight's program with a Four Seasons, but it is not the Four Seasons that you know by heart. This Four Seasons by Guido is thought to be inspired by Vivaldi's Four Seasons. Each season begins with a poem, and for that, we will welcome back the very wonderful Suzanne Nance.
Time flies, mortals. We fly with it. Night follows the day and makes way for dawn. Each season flees and hurries to blossom. Let's taste the sweet delights, for we live today. Spring, the sad winter is no more. Spring takes its place. Everything is reborn with it. Everything laughs on our hillsides. The creeks in their beds no longer find ice, and the fields are open to the bouncing herds. The sweet nightingale with twittering charm complains of love or sings of happiness. All the birds in different languages expressing the secrets of their hearts. What sound hits the air? The loud trumpet warning the warriors, announcing battles. Fight, heroes. Fly to the shining glory from a distant victory or a noble death. And you, happy shepherds, tune your bagpipes. The sheep graze all around at will. Dances, songs in your sweet retreats. Nurture as many fires as the tender gazes.
Thank you.
summer, the air catches fire. Phoebus, on a shining course, has already encountered the angry lion. Zephyr disappears. The burning countryside does not let any bird sing besides the cuckoo. Fly to our rescue, O lovely Ceres. Come honor our fields with your divine charm. Curb the fearsome heat of the sun, that it gilds our harvests and does not burn them. She goes down and all feel her presence. Let's celebrate its blessings with soft chords. Harvesters, reap among the abundance. Begin the glory to pick her treasures. Fawns and pretty nymphs find spring once again in the middle of the woods. Such dances, such laughs, such divine songs. The sad echo follows them and answers to their voices. The respectful lover waits for the dark night. Her martyred lover bursts into the air, not daring to tell the sorrows he endures. He makes people talk for pleasant concerts. But a sudden lightning bolt interrupts his tribute. The sky rumbles, fires a thousand times redoubled, announcing to the earth a violent thunderstorm. And all the senses of the pale mortals are troubled.
Thank you.
Let's celebrate the return of autumn. Let's follow the sweet pleasures and games into the fields. Flora does not rule anymore, but the rich pomona offering in place of flowers more worthy presents. I hear the confused calls and laughs of Bacchus, recognizing Selene and her thunderous voice from the powerful god of wine. In its charming furors, they taste the favors and sing of its exploits. In the arm of sleep, the group gives up. Bacchus just dulled all their enchanted senses. Oh, fortunate drinkers, are the scepter and the crown worth the pleasures that are presented to you? But what troublesome sound wakes them up so early in the morning? The horns sound in all the surrounding woods. Hunters and dogs with an unmatched passion are dying to bring down more than one monster today. The scared deer sees no longer his retreat. It flies and wants to escape death in vain. Strength abandons it, and lamenting over its defeat, it surrenders to the victors, who do not spare it.
Thank you.
Winter. The season of frost saddens nature. The weakened sun shies away from our eyes. The earth of the animals offers, instead of pasture, only snow and icicles that one finds everywhere. The cruel aquilon declares war on us. Some dreadful whistling howls in the air. Furious Sioli to devastate the earth from its mischievous subjects. Has he broken the chains? Take care of your days, O trembling old age. The blow of Boreas is destructive. The warmth of green youth can barely prevent the effect of his wrath. However, our warriors and brilliant celebrations in the middle of the winter bring sunny days. Everything promises the most beautiful conquests. They are guaranteed by the mother of love. Let the winds rumble. Let's banish sadness. The most charming gods foresee our desires. Let's abandon ourselves to feasts, games, tenderness. The winter that freezes everything revives our pleasures.
Thank you.
thank you again for joining us this evening. That concludes tonight's performance, and I want to first acknowledge the incredible musicians of Portland Baroque Orchestra, Carla Moore, and Suzanne Nance for tonight's performance. I also want to thank PBO's staff who made this possible. This live stream was only an imaginary idea on Monday morning when we thought this might be coming at us. And so I'd like to thank our staff, Jasmine Cunningham, Matt Eiler, Andrea Hess, and Rachel Smith. And of course, our media consultant and camera guy, Adam Lansky. Thank you all so much. And finally, thanks to you, to all of you watching. Great art is impossible and unimaginable without people to love it. And so thank you so much for being with us. We look forward to welcoming you back in person at some point in the future. And until then, we hope to see you more on the internet. Thank you so much for all you do. Be well and good night.